great to be back home. And when I was extended the invitation to be here several months ago, I was concerned about the weather maybe being a problem, but I thought it would be from New York City, not here in Hattiesburg, but neither rain nor sleet nor snow was going to keep me from being here to say congratulations to each and every one of you right here. So incredibly proud of you. Each and every one. Including my beloved niece, Lauren Elizabeth Hinton. She walked across here and graduated from the School of Nursing. And I said to my sweet niece, I said, what can Auntie Robin give you as a graduation gift? And she said, you can give a short speech. So that will be my gift to not only my niece, but the rest of you, because this is your moment. This is what you have worked for. This is about you, your hard work, your sacrifices. This is about your loved ones, your family, for their support and sacrifices to bring you to this very moment. I gotta tell you, you have put yourself in position for good things, no, great things to happen to you. I believe in proximity being power. Proximity is power. You can wish, hope, and pray all you want, but you have to position yourself for success. And you have done that. And I have to say, when I was sitting where you are at my graduation, I had no idea what I was going to be doing Monday morning. And some of you may know, and some of you may not, but you have positioned yourself for some good things to happen. I didn't know sitting at my graduation that just months later, my career would be launched in your backyard. WDAM was my first job in television. $5.50 an hour, 30 hours a week as a weekend sports anchor, and I was happy to have that position. Grateful, grateful to everyone there at WDAM, still am. And I didn't know at the time that I was going to be doing that, and I did receive some full-time offers, but I wanted to be a sports reporter. That was my passion at the time, my purpose. It brought me joy. So remember that. Purpose, passion, joy. Purpose, passion, joy. And that's what I felt. And I was dreaming big, but focusing small. And I encourage you to do that same thing. Dream big, but focus small on those day-to-day things that can ultimately get you to whatever your goal is. And only you know what it is that you want to achieve, but you are only in competition with yourself. Only you can be you, and no one can be better at being you than you. So don't worry. And if you worry, you know, when you're looking at people who have achieved a level of success, you notice how focused they are and how determined they are on their goals. They're so focused that they're not concerned about what other people are doing. And if somebody should pass you, give them a high five and keep running your race. What is your destiny? What is your destination? Because we all are a little bit fearful of making mistakes, and you will make mistakes, but I look at it as being chances that we take. And it's all about perspective. You gotta change the way you think in order to change the way you feel. And I just wanna say, continue to put yourself in a position for great things to happen. Be willing to make the necessary sacrifices. Dream big and focus small. And as I look across one of your alum, my sister, Sally Ann Roberts, who gave me life by being my bone marrow donor, she is a part of this USM family of which you are a part. So when fear knocks, let faith answer the door. And yes, Southern Miss, to the top, baby. Congratulations.